I mean, working now. How many years?
It's about 4 years now since I started to work in IT field.
Oh,
I work
good.
with like different places, and it's about like 4 years now. I worked in like five different places and five different jobs. Yeah, it's kind of like that, because most of them, I had one job I did for 3 years, and the other
To teach here, and you're going to practice from your end directly, so which is going to be allow you to learn while not listening only. So when I'm teaching itself, you are going to practice in your system, and it's going to be completely related to practical oriented. So you, the way the, because of your learning while practicing itself, you can stick to the job for lifelong. You don't need to worry about, like, you know, how, okay, who can help me in the future, and how can I sustain in the market. You don't need to worry about all those things, and ever all the content will be covered in the form of a project. So it's going to be very easy for you to remember the subject. Okay, so yeah, this is way how I'm going to teach it. Let me start our demo. If you have any questions, please write them down. And if you have any questions, we'll discuss end of the class, or, you know, maybe next class, something like that. If you have any other questions, we add it and all. And everyday basis, we'll be giving the demo. I mean, once you finish the class, I want you to go through the recording, and I want you to prepare your own notes. And while preparing the notes, if you have any questions, any doubts, again, you can prepare them as a separate question bank or separate thing, which is going to cover your certification question, which is going to cover your doubts, and all the clarification can be done in the next class itself again. Okay, so any more questions before starting the demo?
No, I'm fine.
Okay. Cool. So before just letting you know what is Salesforce.com, I just want to find out, do you have any idea on cloud computing, and why do we need to go for cloud computing, and what is the Salesforce.com, and how is Salesforce.com came into the market? So my agenda will be like, you know, what is cloud computing, and where is Salesforce.com part of cloud computing, and why me, you, everybody are behind Salesforce.com. Okay, and why the job openings are there more for Salesforce.com. So this is my agenda. I don't want to take into the subject directly, because you need to know the basics of cloud computing, and what is Salesforce.com, and why is it in the market. So why we are all behind Salesforce.com. We need to know all these things. Okay, so can you please let me know what exactly you know about cloud computing? Whatever the idea you have on cloud computing, please let me know. So let me invite you, because I don't want to speak myself. Okay, I want you to understand, I want you to speak some words, so it's going to be easy for you, and to let even I can understand how you are aggressive when asking the questions like that. So it's going to be easy for you to learn, remember the subject.
Okay, like in what field are you talking about when you talk about computer? Like I know computing is very wide. When you talk about, it can be you mean cloud computing, or
okay. So maybe you might be having an idea when you're going through the research, when you're doing some research, when you're learning, when you're reading some books online, or during your studies, you might see some kind of, you know, sky blue color cloud symbol will be shown, something like this, and they're going to call it as internet. They're going to call it as internet over there. So do you have any idea why they're choosing only this cloud symbol as internet? They can choose like some kind of apple, some kind of banana, or some other symbol, and they can call it as internet, right? But why do they choose only the cloud symbol, and why do they call it as internet? So here only the main question is going to come into the picture here. Okay, so generally, when anybody asks you some question, when you are there in the company, when you are there in the public, or someone, okay, and officially, if someone asks you some question to you, if you don't have any answer, okay, so generally, how everyone will react? Simply looking at the sky and say that we don't know. When you say we don't know, our both the hands, their fingers will show towards the sky, and our face also look at towards the sky, and our hands, our face, everything look towards at the sky. Okay, what we're able to see in the sky now, except the clouds, we don't see anything. And when you look at this, when you look at any specific cloud, okay, do you have any physical shape for the cloud? Do you have any physical location for the cloud? Do you have any kind of physical distance for the cloud? We don't have anything, right? So the when we don't have any answer, we're referring to the cloud. We're just looking at the sky and say that I don't know. So this is the answer what we're getting. In the same way, when everybody working on internet, so nowadays without internet, nothing will be possible over there. You want to log into Gmail, you want to log into Facebook, you want to do some Google search, or whatever you want to do it, end of the day you are going to use with the help of your internet over there. Okay? So now the question is going to come to you again. So do you know how the internet looks like? Do you know where the internet located? Do you know the physical shape of internet? Do you have any idea how the internet looks like, where it exists over there, how they are going to give it to you? We don't know anything, right? Just this is simply a service where we are going to use it to work on multiple number of other applications over there. That's it. Am I right? So the question will come to you, what is internet means? We don't have any idea. Again, we are looking at the sky and say that we don't know. So this is the exact answer you are looking for. So the big vendors who are developing their application, which are going to be run with the help of internet, they have to call it as internet application or internet technologies or internet computing, something like that. So the vendors who want to call it as internet application, internet technology, internet computing, so they don't want to give the same name as it is now, because everybody have a cheap mentality on the word internet. Why? Because if you pay monthly like 1,000 rupees or $100 over there, you are going to get a high speed network connection and you can do whatever you want to do it. If you pay like, you know, $1 per hour, you can get like whatever you want to get, however you want to do it, you can do it over there. So this kind of cheap mentality was there in the public market. So the big vendors who are developing their application, they have to call it as internet application, internet technologies or internet computing. So what they did here is, they want to replace the name internet with some other word. So that should be very catchy, that should be very easy to understand. So the word what they're choosing is going to be cloud computing, cloud over there. Okay. So internet is the one word that has been replaced by the word cloud over there. Okay. Apart from that, whatever the there no special technology, cloud computing, cloud technologies, cloud application, cloud service, nothing is there. Cloud is nothing but your internet over there. Cloud is equivalent to your internet. Is it clear up to this point?
Yes.
Is it clear, right? Hope you are following.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the way how all the cloud computing came into the market. Okay. So what are the technologies that are working on with the help of internet? They are going to call them a cloud application or cloud technologies or cloud computing. Okay. So there are no specific technology related to cloud computing. There are no specific meaning of cloud, something like that. Everything is going to be very straightforward, and we cannot run anything without your Salesforce cloud computing. Okay. Now. So when the vendors are developing their application, when the developers are manufacturing their application, developing their application, running their application, they have to provide as part of some kind of internet service over there. So to provide them as a service, they divide the complete cloud computing modules into three modules over there. First one is SaaS module, we are going to call it. SaaS module, we are going to call it. Second one is going to be PaaS module. Okay. And last one is going to be IaaS, we are going to call it IaaS. Okay, so SaaS is nothing but software as a service. Next one is going to be platform as a service. Then next one is going to be infrastructure as a service. So whatever the application we are going to run with the help of Salesforce.com, whatever the application we are going to run with the help of Salesforce.com, we are going to make sure that these are going to be part of any one of these three modules of cloud computing. So there may be a number of other modules also available like SaaS, PaaS, IaaS, but the main application all over the world, that whatever they are going to be developing over there, they may be part of either SaaS or PaaS or IaaS over there. Okay, now we'll go and see how our Salesforce is going to be part of these services and where we are going to be part of this cloud computing module, and then we'll proceed to what exactly you need to, why exactly we are behind Salesforce.com like that. Okay, so when I go for SaaS, PaaS, IaaS, what do you mean by SaaS? Any idea on this?
Service as a software as a service.
Exactly. That's going to be called software as a service over there. Okay. Software as a service. Next one is the platform as a service. Next one is going to be infrastructure as a service. So everything. Everything is going to run with the help of internet, and they're going to call it as they're going to provide them as a service to all the customers all over the world. Okay. And all of them are going to run with the help of internet only. Okay. So because service means always we are going to run with the help of internet. That's the default thing we are going to keep in mind. Now, we'll go in detail and what exactly the SaaS and how exactly we are going to define it over there and what is exactly PaaS and what are the modules provided by SalesForce.com. We'll see all of them together one by one. Okay. Now, you are using Gmail, right? You are using Gmail. So, Gmail is a software as a service. The question to you is Gmail.com is a service or a software?
Gmail, it's a service, it's not a software.
It's not a software, but it is a service. But how do
yes.
we call it as a service? Why you need to call it as a service? We can call it as a software, right? But why we are going to call it as a service? Is there any special meaning of why you are going to call it a service?
I mean, because basically Gmail is not like a software we install somewhere and we use.
Exactly,
Gmail is a service.
Exactly.
Through the cloud, through the internet. It's a service
exactly.
by the internet.
Yes. So Gmail.com is a service for all of us. Gmail.com is a service for all of us because we are not installing anything, we are not configuring anything. We're simply getting accessing Gmail.com. See, wherever you see .com, that's going to call a service again. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
So wherever you have a domain called .com, .co.in, whatever is going to be, generally we are going to call them a service over there. So for those things, we are not going to install anything, we are not going to do hardware or nothing is needed over there. So in your local laptop, if you have the net connection, you can simply go for service over there. That's it.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's a service for all of our customers. So you, me, and everybody who is using Gmail.com, we're all customers over there. But if you want to use this service, somebody has to provide the service to you, right? So somebody has to develop this software, somebody has to install somewhere, and they need to provide a service for all of us. So Gmail.com is a service for all of the customers, but Gmail.com is a software for Google.com company over there. Gmail.com is a software for Google.com company, and they're going to provide to all of us as a service over there. You got it? So Google.com developed a software called Gmail. They have installed in their server called Gmail, and they're going to provide to all the customers as a service over there. So the software has been installed in the remote location, the Google server. They're going to provide to all the customers as a service over there. This model we are going to call as software as a service model. Software as a service model we are going to call it. Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, so Gmail is the best example you can say then as part of your SaaS module over there. Okay, so Google.com started Gmail.com in 1999. Okay, in 1999 Gmail started, and they started providing to all over the world all the customers for free of cost. So when Google.com started Gmail.com as a free service for all over the world, one of the executive, his name is Mark Benioff. Okay, one of the executive, his name is Mark Benioff, and he used to work for Oracle till 1999. He used to request all the customers to come and buy the Oracle software over there. But all the small and medium companies will not come and purchase the Oracle software because very, very expensive. Because Oracle is a very big software company. Before we born in the market, it exists. And it's very difficult to attract the small and medium companies to use the Oracle software. So in 1999, when Google.com started Gmail.com as a free service over there, he got the same idea saying that, okay, when Google.com able to provide the free application for all over the world, okay, why can't I develop one application? Why can't I develop one application, okay, that will be installed in the Oracle server over there, and I can provide the access to this application with a minimal cost all over the world, all the industries. Whoever want to use it, they can use it. However they want to use it, they can use it like that. Okay, they provide one application. They want to install the application and in the Oracle server, and they want to provide the access to all over the world for all the customers, for any kind of industry, any kind of requirement, you can do it with the help of minimal cost over there. So that's the reason the application came. They tried to install this application. When Mark Benioff told this plan to Oracle executive, they told that we don't want to use these kind of cheap services of using internet over internet. Okay, they don't want to use the cheap service of internet. So in 1996 itself, they feel like, you know, Oracle feel like, you know, internet is going to become very cheap. So we don't want to use this cheap service over there. So they throw him out, and they told that we don't want you to stay in our company anymore, so please go out and start your own company. So in 1999, Mark Benioff came out, he started his own company, and the company name they kept is going to be kept was salesforce.com. Okay, the company name what they kept was salesforce.com. See, again, the domain is going to be .com over there, and the product what they launched is salesforce.com CRM, or we are going to call them as SFA, we are going to call it. Okay, so in the salesforce.com server, the application will be built in, and with this built-in application, they are providing, like, you know, as per the surveys, 60 to 70% of the standard functionality by default, whatever they're providing, it will be available by it's going to be available, it's going to be configurable to meet any kind of requirement, whatever the work you want to do, everything can be done with the help of your existing functionality being provided by salesforce.com application over there. Okay, so in 1999, they started their own company called salesforce.com, and they started providing the services from 2001 onwards. Okay, from 2001 onwards, they started providing services, and as of now, 2016, it has been acquired by almost 2,44,000 customers are using salesforce.com for now. 2,44,000 customers, 2,44,000 plus customers are using salesforce.com for their requirement, for their clients, and however they want to use it, they can use it over there. So the first product what they launched is salesforce.com CRM, which is they're going to change, they're going to save like 60 to 70% of the functionality by default available that can be utilized by any kind of industry, that can be utilized by any kind of requirement, whatever you want to do it, you can do it over there. There's no restriction for utilizing this kind of existing functionality. Okay, so by everybody started using, by the time you come to like 2002, something like that, so almost like, you know, 1,500 customers started using salesforce.com for the requirement. So some small companies who don't have the proper budget, they can make utilize of this 60 to 70% as 100% for some time, and the big companies, they want to start from the scratch. So by default, feel like, you know, salesforce.com is going to provide the black and white screens over there. We don't have any kind of colorful navigation over here. So some companies feel that, yes, I like salesforce.com very much, but I don't want to use the standard functionality. Okay, so what do? They started subscribing for salesforce.com, but they're not going to utilize, they're not going to configure from the scratch over there. So they want to start from the 0% again, or 10% again, something like that. So everybody looking for, again, some kind of alternatives again. Okay, they want to use salesforce.com for the requirement, they want to use salesforce.com, plus they want to integrate with some other technologies over there. It may be a Java, or it may be a .NET, it may be SAP, or it may be SQL, it may be Oracle, or any other technology. If they want to customize their functionality, if they want to get some new functionality added to existing functionality of salesforce.com of 60 to 70%, everybody, all the customers started relying on your normal technology over there. So, but salesforce.com motto is, don't go for software. We don't want to use any more software over there. We want get everybody to start using as a service over there. If you are getting any kind of service-based application or to get your requirement, well and good. Otherwise, don't go for this software, because our motto is to reduce the cost. Because their motto is to reduce the cost and to reduce the time and to make sure that whatever you want to get it done, you can get that done with the help of your service-based application over there. But if you go for Java, .NET, SAP, SQL, all of them are going to be part of your software-based only. Okay, we don't want to go for any kind of service software based over there. We don't want to configure, we don't want to install something either. So they started, because to stop their customers not to being used by Java, .NET or something like that. So whatever the functionality you are going to get with the help of your Java, .NET, SAP, all these software technologies, they want to provide with the help of their own programming language. So they introduce their own programming language called Apex Programming, and they introduce their own design pages called, you know, Visual Force Pages. Okay, so to write this coding part, to design the pages, again, you should be having some kind of platform over there. Okay, and for writing the Java programming or .NET programming, SAP scripting or SQL scripting or Oracle database, everything, again, you need to have a platform. Okay, but what are the platforms we have now in the market, or Eclipse or MSDN, or all of them are going to be software based. Okay, but our salesforce main motto is going to be, we don't want to go for software based over there, but we want to go for as a service based over here. So to write the coding part of Apex programming and Visual Force pages, salesforce.com need to introduce a platform, and the platform what they introduce is a force.com platform they introduced over there. Force.com. So the platform origin it is force.com platform over there. Okay, so force.com is a platform which is provided or which is installed in Salesforce.com server, and they're going to provide to all of the customers as a service over there. So what is the platform name we are getting here? Force.com is a platform we are getting here.
Okay.
Is it clear, Raja? Okay, and
yes.
With the help of your force.com platform, okay, so what are the existing functionality you are going to get here? The 60 to 70% of the standard functionality, generally we are going to call them CRM functionality. We can configure the existing functionality, you can customize the existing functionality, and you can extend the existing functionality to meet your further requirements over here. So our Salesforce.com technology is going to be part of your both SaaS plus PaaS over there. Okay, so as part of SaaS, we are going to get the 60 to 70% of the default existing functionality that can be utilized by any kind of industry, any kind of requirement, whatever the work you want to do, you can do it. And to extend the existing functionality, to start from the scratch by using Salesforce.com, or to write your own coding part, everything can be done with the help of your platform called Force.com platform. So Force.com platform can be used to write the Apex programming, which is nothing but your Java programming, we can say, or we can say like, you know, C# programming, and we have some kind of visual force pages over there, which is nothing but your ASP or HTML or maybe JSP, or what are the designing application we are going to start it, we are going to referring to the visual force pages over there. Okay, not only this Apex programming, not only the beautiful pages, whatever you want to configure or however you want to modify the existing functionality to meet your requirement, that will be done with the help of your both the modules over there. Okay, so our Salesforce.com is going to be part of only SaaS plus PaaS modules over there. Is it clear up to this part?
Yes, so you say the sales, it's a non-programming platform, right?
Yes, it's possible with the help of non-programming as well as a programming. Because when you go for here 60 to 70%, all of them are going to be non-programming side. So by default, without writing a single line of code, how do you develop the application? So that is going to be developed, that is going to be done with the help of your 60 to 70% that we are going to cover during our class tenure. Okay, so generally is to say like, you know, it's going to be complete admin part, something like that, but no, with the help of existing functionality, you can develop your own application. Okay, generally everybody say develop an application means again start writing the coding part, but when you come to the Salesforce.com, this is going to be like, you know, point click development we are going to call it. Point click development, that means we are going to point out, we are going to click on it, and then we are going to develop it. With the help of your mouse and keyboard only, we can develop your application. You are not going to write even single line of code to develop your application over there. Okay, whatever is not possible here and whatever is not going to be possible to customize your screen, then you are going to rely on your PaaS module to get your programming done called Apex programming and visual force pages over there. Okay, so that's the reason we are dividing the course into two tracks. That's going to be like, you know, track one, track two, generally used to say.
Yes.
That's going to be called, you know, non-coding side and coding side. Non-coding side, we are going to develop the application with the help of your existing functionality, where we are going to simply utilize the existing functionality and how do you make it converted into your, meet your requirement. And whichever is not possible, with the help of your existing functionality, we are going to utilize the Java program, sorry, Apex programming and visual force pages, and then we are going to override the existing functionality to meet your requirement.
So what about the programming part? Which language? What is the language, the programming language?
Yes, exactly. The language what I mentioned already is Apex programming. So this is going to call Apex programming. Okay, so that is equivalent to like, you know, Java programming, if you know. Okay, and that's equivalent to your C# programming. So C# is a dedicated technology for Microsoft. Java program is dedicated for Sun Microsystem. Now it is part of Oracle, and Apex is for Salesforce.com over there.
Oh.
Okay, and for Java, the combination might be like, you know, JSP or HTML, something like that, and backend is going to be Oracle, something like that. Okay, and for C# we have like, you know, ASP or ASP.NET, and this is going to be frontend, and backend is going to be SQL Server, something like that. So every technology, they have their own dedicated UI, dedicated programming, dedicated backend, something like that. The same way for Salesforce.com also, Apex is the dedicated program language for Salesforce.com, and to design the pages, Visual Force we are going to call it. And we don't have anything specifically like another database over there. So as part of your Salesforce existing functionality, we are going to get something called objects over here, and which we are going to use it in the form of like, you know, SOQL like that. SOQL. So this is going to be your database over here, and all of them will be converted automatically into programming into sales.com service over there. Whatever you write the coding, what are the tables you are going to design, what are the pages you are going to design, all of them combined together is going to be available as part of your SaaS module again. Once you started designing that, everything will be converted into a SaaS module and you can use however you want to use it over there.
Mm-hmm.
Any more doubts here up to this part before I move to IAS? Is it clear, Ashok?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay, so the last module of cloud computing, generally we are not part of this IaaS module is IaaS. Okay, what do you mean by IaaS here? Infrastructure as a service. Infrastructure as a service, we are going to call it. So what is the meaning of infrastructure here is, okay, generally if you want to start your own business, own company over there, so without building, without location, we are not going to go for starting any kind of process over there. So in the same way, so to start your software project over there, how many hardwares we want to have it, how many softwares we want to have it, and what kind of licenses you are going to purchase over there, what kind of servers you are going to maintain, what kind of other activities you are going to maintain, all of them are going to be provided in the form of a application over there. To get this application ready, we need to have so many things over here. Okay, so if the company doesn't have it, if the company doesn't have a proper if the company doesn't have a proper resources like this, what we're going to do here is, suppose you come to me, suppose Isaac come to me to get a service done by Nandu over there. Okay, so but I don't have a facility to provide these services to you directly, like how many hardware I can provide you, something like that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to contact some other company who are going to provide these kind of application services as a lease basis. I'll be connected to these services. I'm going to do my work, okay, and then once I completed my work over there, I'm going to assign it to some other client over there. Okay, you are coming to me to do a project, get that done for your requirement, but I don't have the facility, I don't have the hardware, software, all of them, I don't have the capacity of building my own server, something like that. So whoever is going to provide the server, software on a lease basis over there, so I will be connected to them, I'm going to get my work done, and then once whatever the work I'm done doing now, I'll be assigned to my client over there. This is going to be like a round-robin process. So instead of not only the client and the customer, instead of not only the client and the vendor who are doing the project, we are going to involve some third-party companies over there. Just for example, Amazon. Okay, so they are going to provide, like, you know, how much space you want to have it, what kind of servers you want to have it, what kind of software you want to have it, and same thing is your IBM over there. So they are going to provide the complete infrastructure to do your project over there, and which will not be stored, which will not be configured either on the client side or on the vendor side. They are going to keep in their company only. Whoever want to utilize their functionality with the services, they are going to get a lease for the services, and once you done your project, you are going to hand out to the client over there. And when you look back over there, you are going to pay more money to all the third party services you are going to get from the infrastructure based companies over here, because either the client or the company who are doing the project will not own any kind of hardware, will not own any kind of software, will not own any kind of firewall, something like that, because everything we are going to get the lease based over there. But when you look at the long term point of view, it's going to be very, 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 very expensive compared to have your own software, own hardware like that. Okay, this simple, like, you know, if you want to understand simply, so paying a monthly rent of $20,000 for a flat is different, and paying the $20,000 as a EMI or a installment for a bank is different. Okay, if you go for a loan, after 10 years or 15 years of clearing the amount, at least the house or the flat will be on your own. But if you're paying as a rent over there, even if you pay 10 years, 20 years, something like that, you never be own the flat. You are simply still owning, you are simply paying the rent for the lease of using the flat. So when you look at the long-term point of view, it's going to be very, very expensive to store using the infrastructure service over there. Okay, so this is a simple example I can say from the cloud computing side. So the application will be built in some third-party company. From there, you are going to get access for your client and for your customers, something like that. So it's going to be very, very expensive compared to normal technologies over there. So our sales.com is not part of your IaaS module over there. Okay, so these are the three modules part of your cloud computing. First one is the SaaS, second one is the PaaS, and then third one of IaaS of cloud computing. And from cloud computing, our sales platform is going to be part of only SaaS plus PaaS over there. Okay, so if you're fine with this, then I'll make sure that you'll understand why we're all behind Salesforce.com, where we are saving, where Salesforce.com is going to save us the cost and save us the time and providing more flexibility, where you can get the existing functionality. We'll see all of them together one by one. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You fine, Ajak? You're able to follow?
Yes.
Okay, so generally, if you want to start a new project, okay, forget about Salesforce.com, forget about cloud computing. If you want to start a new project over there, what exactly you need to have from the end-to-end project? So from the day one you start your project by gathering the requirements and everything together, what exactly you need to have?
I mean, you need other, you have more information about the project, you need to know what you want to do.
Exactly. So apart from that, then you need to know the technologies, what technologies you need to utilize here, what softwares you want to use, what databases you want to use, how many servers you want to use. Okay,
yeah.
All of them needed, right? So generally first you need to go for, like, you know, application software. We are going to get it. First one is going to be application software. So it's maybe example of, like, you know, Java, common .NET or SAP, CPS, something like that. And this is only for, you know, front-end purpose and writing the coding part purpose. Okay? Then you are going to have the back-end that's going to call database software over there. Okay? So the developers, people who are working on the development side or designing the pages, they're going to work on the application software. And the people who are responsible for database maintenance, they're going to work on the database software by creating SQL servers or Oracle examples, something like that. Okay? So once you have the tables ready, once you have the application coding part ready, you need to store them in a separate place over here. To store the application software, all the classes or the designing pages done, you need to make them in a place called application servers, we are going to call it. Application servers. Okay, same thing with your database, we are going to maintain something in the place called database servers over there. Okay, so how many servers you want to have it, how many database servers you are going to have it again. So generally you are going to have some kind of environments over there. Okay, so if minimal if you go there also, first development should be there, plus testing should be there, plus staging, then production, something like that. So one server for the application, one server for the database, and one server for the testing, one server for the database, one server, one thing on the production side, okay, for application, for database. So like that, a minimum six servers are needed to get one project done over there. And that too, this is only for one location. That too, this is for only one location. Suppose if anything happened to this one location, you need to get the backup. So you are going to go for the number of locations you are going to get it over there. Okay. Suppose you maybe have your code in Texas, you maybe have a data server in Chicago, you may go for some other, like, California, something like that. So wherever your location is there, you need to maintain separate backup. Suppose something happened to this current location, Texas, you might go for Chicago or California, some other location, and you can get your things done ready over there. Okay, so these things are going to be possible with the help of your remote locations over the virtual machine. Okay, and all of them are going to run with to run your project only. Okay, so application servers are going to store the application coding part and designing pages, and database servers are going to use to store the database tables, something like that. And everything will be interconnected again. Okay, everything will be interconnected. Okay, and all of your end users are going to give access to your production. Okay, now, so where are we going to keep these servers? Are we going to just keeping them beside us and we are going to work on the projects? Or are we going to keep a separate place over there? Generally, we are going to call them a storage room, or we are going to call them a server room, something like that. Okay, or we are going to call official terms is going to be, like, you know, data centers, we are going to call it. I hope you are following. Okay,
You said we're gonna be creating softwares, cloud software. So
no. What I meant to say is, okay, forget about Salesforce for some time and cloud computing for some time. When you go for any kind of traditional software technology, okay. So these are the modules what we are going to get it done to get your application ready, end to end project. Okay, to implement any kind of project from the day one to day end. Okay, what are the exact things you needed to complete a software project over there? Software companies, how they're going to do it. Okay, so I want to compare all these things versus Salesforce.com. Okay, so to get your software project done, we are going to have application software. It may be Java, .NET, something like that. And to store the data of your application, you need to go for database software. That's going to be called SQL Server, Oracle, something like that. And what are the coding part you are going to get it done here? We are going to store them in a place called application server and then database servers. And you are going to keep these servers just beside your data in the data center over there. Okay, and to maintain all these applications, okay, database application or application software, database software, application server, database server, data centers, we need to have some kind of administrators over there. We have to have your administrator. So what of administrator we are going to have? A network administrator, it may be a system administrator, it may be a Windows administrator, you may be like a database administrator. All these are going to be different types of roles we are going to have in your company as part of your administration. Okay, all these people need to work like 24/7 to make sure that, you know, your application is going to be run thoroughly. Okay, and then after this, end of the day, your management might ask you to do some kind of analysis on your data. Okay, so then again, you need to go for some kind of reporting tools over there. Reporting tools you need to go. To work on the reporting tools, again, you need to go for some kind of reporting team over there. Okay, so reporting tools examples are going to be like, you know, MSBI, it may be like OBI, it may be some other technologies like, you know, Tableau, ClickView, something like that. Again, to work on these technologies, you need to have a separate team over there again. Okay, and if you want to work from home for your project, you need to maintain some kind of virtual private network. Again, you need to go for some kind of firewall over there. Okay, again, if you want to use VPN or firewall, all of them to be connected to each other, again, you need to go for high-speed network connection, you need to use it over there. Got it? So to get one single project done, again, we need to have so many modules to need to be ready, then only your application will be up and running over there. And hope you remember, all these application software, database software or servers, you are going to pay the money first, and then you are going to get registered on the client name. Hope you understand this. Okay, suppose if it's going to be like 100 license over there, all the 100 license for annual basis you are going to pay in the beginning of the project, and then you are every year you are going to renewal cost over there. So for all the modules what we got it over there, every year you need to go for the renewal cost. Every year you are going to go for the renewal cost. Every year going to go for the renewal cost will be increasing over there. Okay, so if you have 100 license over there, all the 100 license you need to increase over there. So first year it may be like a $2,000 per license. Okay, next time it may be like, you know, $3,000 per license. The cost may be increased, so your annual cost also going to be increased over there. Okay, apart from that, and every year, suppose if you start the project in 2002 or 2003, something like that. In 2016 also, are you going to use the same version nowadays?
Did you make nothing up?
Exactly, we are going to go for application, or we are going to version management, something like that. So you, whenever you got the new versions, new plugins over there, again you need to upgrade your application as per your meet requirement. Okay, it may be like, you know, version 1.1, something like that in 2002, or then it's going to go for 2.0, 3.0, something like that. Every time your versions keep on increasing, so you need to upgrade all of your software also. When you're going to upgrade your application software, compared with that, you need to go for database software. Okay, when you upgrade your application software, database software, again, you need to go for like, you know, application server and then database servers over there. Okay, not only that, every 2.5 years, you need to replace your servers over there. Every 2.5 years you need to replace the server, and whenever you are going to update your application software, database software, application server, database server, again you need to provide the proper knowledge sharing for your administrators also. An admin cannot come and say that I know only 2002 version, I don't know how to work on 2016 ways. The person will not be having the job in the market. Okay, so the people also need to be upgraded, right? So whenever the new versions are going to come, the admins people also need to be upgraded themselves. Okay, but who is going to provide the knowledge for them again? Again, the client or the company who are doing this project, who are sponsoring the project, they need to provide the knowledge sharing. Administrator, like it may be database administrator, it may be network administrator, it may be system administrator, whatever the type of people working on this project, everybody get their knowledge to be improved over there. So when you look back at the yearly point of view, your cost will keep on increasing only. Okay, so because every year, every unit to go for renewal cost, every unit to go for upgrade version over there, every unit to go for the lot of trainings to be conducted for all of your team members, so your cost will keep on increasing only. Your cost will keep on increasing only. Okay, so there won't be any kind of ending point in spending the money on your normal software technologies over there. okay, and it might take like, you know, 12 months, 13 months, 14 months, 15 months, depends upon the project requirement. You might be keep on extending the project over there. So that's the reason no project manager, no CIO, no CFO can say that we spent only so much of money on this project. Okay, nobody can say that this is the final amount I spent on this project, something like that. Nobody can say that. Okay, why? Because every year you need to go for renewal cost, every 2.5 years replace the servers over there, VPN is going to be very, very expensive to maintain, firewall, something happened to firewall again, you need to replace the firewall with new firewall, so your cost will keep on increasing only. Okay, so that's the reason the no product manager, no CIO can say that we spent only so much of money over there.
So, okay? which means you're not going to be the administrator, but you're going to be the developer of the software. And they're gonna the client, the company will have another someone who will be like the administrator of the software you create.
Exactly. So suppose, for example, if you feel a software technology over there, software project, you started developing the project in 2002. Okay, and 2003 you completed the project, okay, and the client started using the project, and to maintain this project from the client side, they might have their own administrators. Okay, so if you have any new enhancements coming, again from the company side who developed the project, they should be having a developer, they should be having support in something like that. So your continuous support will be there, continuous modification will be there, continuous administration will be there. Okay, both administrators and developers will be there on both the sides to make sure that the application is going to run up and running over there. That's the reason I'm saying that this application will never stop, because when I started using Nokia 2100 basic mobile in the beginning, how do you feel it? So you might experiment like, you know, I want to have some kind of touch version, I want to go for a smartphone, I want to go for Bluetooth, without Bluetooth, I want to have with Bluetooth. So all the new versions, when you are going to get it, you are going to upgrade your mobile, or you are going to replace the mobile, or you are going to get some other version. Okay, same way, when the client started using their application, okay, every year depends upon the feedback, as per the latest technologies, you need to upgrade your existing application also. So to get the existing application migrated to the new version, again you need to go for the plugins, you need to get it, new version of software, you need to get it, again every year you need to go for the renewal cost over there. Okay, so lifelong, your project will be there lifelong. Suppose just started using Gmail, maybe Gmail also going to be another application, or what are the application you are working on in the laboratory, what you had mentioned, okay, so the version you have it is different. I'm sorry, Ajay, repeat again.
It's going to be like a lifetime project, lifetime, because the company will keep using the software, and they will still need you to help them for the software, for the administration, for updates and all the
exactly.
stuff.
Exactly. This is because of the software.
Oh.
Okay. This is because the project has been developed by the help of your software technologies. Okay. So Java is a open source software. .NET is a technology by Microsoft. Oracle is a software by Oracle company. Okay, SQL Server is by Oracle, SQL is by Oracle. So all this kind of software technologies only. Even if you go for IBM, they're going to provide the servers. Okay, they're going to Qualcomm, they're going to go for servers. So like that, to complete your project from day one to day end, if you feel as a project manager or CIO, entire project you need to have all these modules. Okay, whatever discussed here, application software, database software, all of them combined together only, your project will be ready. Your software technology software will be ready. Okay, so suppose if you have started using any kind of mobile application over there, are you going to use the same version every day basis? There may be some new updates are going to come again.
Yeah,
again, you need to install the updates again. But who is going to develop the application updates? So how do we push them to the client, all the clients over there? Because every time whoever is prepared this, whoever is managed this application, so they need to be ready with the new updates also to start in the market, to get the free from the competition, something like that. So always your competition will keep on increasing every day basis. So that's the reason always recommended to go for updated technologies over there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. So just let me compare with Salesforce.com now. Okay, so for any kind of normal software technologies, from the beginning itself, we are going to have all these things over here. So imagine application software, database software, everything get ready, and you know, everything you spend like, you know, 12 months of time, 11 months of time you spend on it. Almost 11 months of time you spend on it in the normal software project. Just for example, I'm telling you, to compare why Salesforce came into the market. Okay, so I feel like, you know, the project cost like, you know, $10,000, or, you know, it may be like $100,000, something like that, for example. Okay, now, so you spend all the money for your client and you get the project ready, and in the 12th month you called your client for demo. In the 12th month you called your client for a demo, client is coming on everyday basis and is going through the demo, is very much happy, he is daily praising all of you, say that excellent guys, good job, you've done a fantastic job, something like that. Okay, and one fine day client come to you and say that, guys, you've done a fabulous job, fantastic job, and you know, credible, it's too much, it's too much of you know, unexpected thing what's happened for our son. So they can praise you a lot and they can say that, yes, I'm like, it's very, very good, something like that. But one fine day if the client says that, I don't want to use this project anymore because I'm going to shut down my company, okay, because there was a rush in the market, I'm going to shut down my company, so what will you do in that case? Okay, so as a company, you spend 11 months of time with all of your developers, administrators, and you spend from your pocket of $1,000 over there for almost 11 months of time. If you handle the project in the 12th month, the client will pay the money to you of like $120, $120,000, something like that. Okay, or maybe like $200,000, something like that. Okay, and suddenly when the client is going through the demo, he got some bad situation and he's going under bankrupt and he shut down his company. Okay, what will happen in this situation?
Please, I didn't understand. Can you repeat the? Can you repeat, please?
Exactly. Yeah. Suppose, just for example, you these application softwares, database softwares, all of them combined together, you are developing a software almost for 11 months. Okay, you spend 11 months of time. You spend 11 months of time, and you spend from your pocket, you know, 100 lakhs over there, 100,000, okay, $100,000 you spend on this project to complete over there. So the project is ready, and if you hand over this project to your client in the 12th month, the client will go through the project, he'll pay you money, like, you know, $200,000, something like that. Okay, this is the project cost you spent on so much, and this is the profit you are going to get, $100,000 profit you are going to get, just for estimation. Okay, and this is going to be completely like a software which has been designed which are as per your client requirement over there. Okay, feel like you got a client, got some requirement, they send it to you, you spend 11 months of time, and you got like $100,000 as the amount you spend on it, so the total project cost is $200,000 over there, you got only $10,000 as advance, so just feel like that. Okay, now you spent 11 months of time, 12th month you started giving the demo for your client on the project what you developed. Okay, so client is coming daily to your office and he's going through the demos, and one fine day client says that, guys, you've done a fabulous job, fantastic job, and everything is good and everything as expected, but unfortunately because there was a rush in the market, because I was going on a bankrupt, I'm going to shut down my company and I don't want to use this project anymore.
Oh.
Okay, if the client says to you like this, what will you do?
I mean, you can use the software and resell it to someone else. You can reprogram the software and sell it to someone else.
Okay, but I know what are the amount of time you spend on it is going to come back again? What are the costs you spend on it to design the software as per the client requirement, is it going to come back again? Okay, so generally you can redesign it, you can go it and all, but you know, once you develop everything after spending so much of time, it's very, very difficult to sell it for some other person, so some other company. If the same industry, the same client is there, they may be in need of the product, they may not be in need of the product, but you know, till you find the client, the amount you spend on it, the cost you spend on it, the time you spend on it, everything will be lost over there. Okay, because there is no guarantee that some other person will come and purchase the product over there. Or Oracle or Microsoft or IBM or somebody will come to you and say that, guys, your client gone and bankrupt, so please give me my software, I'll give you money to you. Do anybody going to say like that? The Oracle, Microsoft is going to come back to you and say that, guys, your client has been gone bankrupt, I heard from some news, so give me my software back, I'll give you money to you. Nobody will come back to us like this. So what are the amount of time you spend on it, what are the costs you spend on it, everything will be lost over there. Okay, so what are the amount of time, what are the amount of cost you spend on, everything will be lost over there. Okay, so maybe forget about the money, because you might go through the legal cases and then you can get some money over there, but what about the time? Is the time is going to come back again?
No, the time is not going to come back. You lose even your time. It's that would be
Exactly.
a waste of time you use to work for something else.
Yeah, so complete time you are going to lose it, complete time amount of amount you are going to lose it over there. So what about the other people working on the project? As per the rules, as per the NASCOM, generally just to say, like, unless the project is not being used by the client, you cannot use in your you cannot use it in your resumes or CVs. So what about those employees over there? All the employees who spend their time of 11 months over here, everybody's life career is going to be in trouble again. Okay, they may get the job, they may not get the job in different project. That's going to be a problem again. Okay, so when was the biggest recession in the market? Has you had? When was the biggest recession in the market all over the world? Oh, I remember this was in 2008. It was there in 2008 to 2010 completely. Okay, so when there was a biggest recession in the market in 2008, most of the companies were shut down. Most of the companies were shut down over there. So during that time, why do they shut down their companies? Because they don't have the money. Because they don't have. Because they, the client says are bankrupt over there. Because the company not able to pay the money. So almost all the companies they gone. They closed their offices because of the recession in the market. Okay, so during the 2008, most of the companies were shut down. In 2002 also there was a recession, and 2008 was there was, and we might expect any time in future again if you are going through the complete software technology. So all the companies who are closed during the recession are about to close in the recession, whoever face the issues during the recession, everybody looking for alternatives. Okay, if something happen in future again to the market, okay, how do we sustain the market? Okay, what is the flexibility you are going to get it? How do you save the money? How do you save the time? How do you get the money from the client everyday basis? Okay, or every week basis? So everybody looking for an alternative, and at the time the only alternative you got is going to be Salesforce.com is the only alternative we are going to get it over there. Okay, why? Because Salesforce.com is the only technology. Salesforce.com is the only technology coming with the 60 to 70% of the standard functionality that can be utilized by any kind of industry and any kind of business requirement over there. And this is going to be running only with the help of internet. This is running only with the help of internet. Okay, and predefined functionality they are providing over there. Everybody can connect to Salesforce.com and they can do their work for their requirement. And you can tell your client also, guys, we got some new version. We're going to develop your application with the help of Salesforce.com. Please go and log into Salesforce.com through this site. Okay, so everything can be done, because see, here itself the main logic here. So 60 to 70% of the standard functionality by default they're going to provide over there. Okay, but when you go for normal software technologies, you need to go from the scratch again. You need to go for application software, pay the money first, get the licenses registered on your client name, then start writing the coding part. Same thing with your designing pages, same thing with database software. Okay, so everything you need to start from the scratch over there. But for Salesforce.com, because they're providing the 60 to 70% of the standard functionality, okay, so what is the need of application software? Already they provide some built-in functionality. Am I right?
Your voice, so already, your voice is not good. I can't hear.
Hello?
Hello. Now it's clear, because I didn't hear the last thing you said, because it was
okay, fine. For Salesforce.com, we are going to get like 60 to 70% of the standard functionality over there. If you started using Salesforce.com, we are going to get 60 to 70% standard functionality. But what is the need of application software for Salesforce.com? Because already they are providing the built-in functionality that can be utilized by any kind of industry. So if you want to use normal software technologies, you need to do from the scratch. So if you want to go for application software and database software, okay, so you are going to pay, like, you know, in the prepaid basis, you are going to pay the total money for all the 100 licenses. Okay, so for already they are providing the built-in functionality in Salesforce.com, so then what is the need of application software? Okay, when we don't have application software needed, what is the need of database software over there? Okay, and when you don't have application software and database software, what is the need of application servers and then database servers over there? And when you don't have any kind of servers over there, what is the need of data centers? Okay, and what is the need of all the administrators to install the software, to maintain the servers and all of them? Okay, yeah. So none of them are needed here for your Salesforce.com over there, because they are providing the built-in functionality by default, and we are not going to maintain any software, we are not going to maintain any kind of server, something like that.
Yeah.
Okay, and part of reporting, as part of Salesforce.com, 60 to 70% functionality only, they are providing the built-in functionality of reporting tools. Okay, again, what is the need of separate reporting team again? and salesforce.com is already running with the help of internet only. So what is the need of VPN, what is the need of firewalls over there? And we don't need to worry about a high-speed network connection. Okay, so when we are not going to use
apps to save money.
Exactly, when we are not going to use all these things, minimum 60% of the cost you are going to save it, and a minimum 60% of time you are going to save it. As per the surveys done by Forrester or Gartner, you are going to save minimum 60% of the cost and 60% of the time. Okay, if you start using salesforce.com, because of the 60 to 70% standard functionality, because it will provide more flexibility to access wherever you want to have it with the help of internet, minimum 60% of the cost you are going to save it. 60% of the cost you are going to save it. Okay? And 60% of the time you are going to save it over there. Okay? Now tell me, how many companies will sit idle without utilizing these 60% of the cost, 60% of time? Even we can save up to 80%, we can go up to 80% of time also. But salesforce.com employees or salesforce.com consultant or administrators are going to get more salaries compared to any other technology people in the market. Okay, it's not from my own mind, it's not from my own mouth. You can go through the Gartner or Forbes or, you know, all the market top leading market research companies. So they were the one who designed the surveys, and they got the feedback from all the clients all over the world, and they told that 60% of the cost you are going to save it, and 60% time you are going to save it. Okay, now tell me, how many companies will sit idle without utilizing salesforce.com for their requirement? Okay, and we are not going to maintain any software, we are not going to maintain any hardware, we are not going to maintain any firewalls, we don't have much risk over there, nothing is available, everything is provided by default as part of salesforce.com. Okay, even if you go for normal software technologies, you are going to generally, compared to all the software technologies, Java runs very faster over there. But if you do the same application with the which is running on Java, it's going to salesforce.com is going to run like, you know, 5 times faster than your Java application. Okay, so because you're running online, we are not connecting any server directly in your location or different location, you are simply connecting same like your website over there. See, this aw.app.com is one of the application which has been developed by somebody else. I'm not configuring, I'm not downloading, I'm not doing anything over there. For salesforce.com also, they have provided built-in functionality. I can utilize however I want to use it for my requirement over there. Okay, and this is going to be completely like, you know, postpaid functionality over there. The flexibility what they're providing by salesforce.com here is normal technologies. Suppose if the project cost is going to be $200,000 over there, $200,000 over there, you need to pay the total money in the beginning itself. Okay, that means for entire financial year, you are going to lose a lot of interest for this $200,000. Okay, and unless you pay the complete money, your project objects will not be ready. They will not register on the client name. Okay, so this is going to be like, you know, annual basis over there. We are going to say annual basis we are going to call it, and we are going to pay the money in the beginning itself. That's going to call a prepaid basis we are going to call it. Okay, and whenever the new versions are going to come, again you need to pay extra money for all those new softwares over there. This is about your normal software technology. But when I go for salesforce.com, okay, what did they say here is, guys, first use the service and then pay the money. Okay, and you don't need to pay on monthly basis, but you can pay on you don't need to pay on a yearly basis, you can pay on monthly basis over there. See the flexibility here. You are paying $200,000 entire cost in the beginning itself is different, and without using the services, you are going to pay the complete money. So once everything is ready only, then you can start working on the project. But salesforce.com, what they are going to do, first they use the service. Okay, they are saying the first subscribe to salesforce.com, use our service, and then pay for the money for whatever you are using on monthly basis. Okay, so generally salesforce.com is going to be part of, like, you know, pay per use model we are going to call it. Pay per use and pay per month over there. Okay, and this is going to be called, like, you know, postpaid basis. Is it fine, Asha? You understand that?
Yeah, okay. It's clear.
Now tell me, how many companies will sit idle without utilizing salesforce.com? End of the day, everybody, including me, you, everybody who are working in the market and working in software companies, everybody looking for time and cost and the flexibility wherever they want to work. Okay, so there are no other technology in the market going to provide a more flexibility in the form of cost or the time or accessing the application or saving the time. Wherever you go, there, Salesforce is the number one place in the market now. And every year they're going to come with the innovative ideas that can be utilized by all the companies. They're going to get new features over there. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so one more thing. So If everything was good with Oracle, the Salesforce.com should be part of Salesforce.com. In the beginning of the demo, I told you, okay, when the person working for Oracle, he mentioned that we'll develop a small application that can be accessed by all the companies all over the world, however they want to access. Okay, so from 2002 to 2016, almost like 244,000 customers are using Salesforce.com. 244,000 customers are using Salesforce.com over there. This is for Salesforce.com.
Oh.
Okay. So how many employees might be there for Salesforce.com to access these customers, to support these customers? Okay. Again, still the number of customers are increasing. Okay. How Oracle will feel now? Just feel like, you know, Oracle is a very big software company. Before we bought the company, just over there 45, 50 years in the industry of Oracle. Okay. Almost like, you know, 2 lakhs plus customers are there. Okay, and to maintain these 2 lakhs plus customers, almost 1,80,000 employees working for Oracle. Employees, 1,80,000 employees are working there to maintain these 2 lakhs plus customers. Okay, remember the figure here, 2 lakhs plus customers are working there for Oracle, and to maintain these 2 lakhs plus customers, 1,80,000 employees are working for Oracle over there. Okay, now for SFDC, within a short span of time of 2001 to 2016, they got like 2,44,000 customers are using Salesforce.com for their requirement, for their client. Okay, and how many employees might be needed for Salesforce.com? It's a very large, right? We can expect the same ratio of like, you know, 2 lakhs to 180 means 244 to 2, like 220, something like that. Just a 220,000 difference, something you can say, right? But only 19,000 employees working for Salesforce.com all over the world.
Oh.
Only 19,000. Okay, it's not my figure, it's not exact figure also. Maybe I can recommend you to go through the wiki of Salesforce.com and then try to see, and go for a wiki of Oracle and try to see. Okay, so how Oracle will feel now? The person working under you, he proposed some idea to you, you didn't listen to them, you throw him out, and he's getting more money than you. So how do you feel about it now? Don't you feel jealous about that? Definitely, right? This is a normal human tendency. Everybody can feel jealous about, like, you know, the person working under you, he came out, when you sacked them out, they started earning more than you. See, imagine, where is 1,80,000, where is 19,000, where is 40 years of industry, 40 plus years of industry, where is only 15 years of industry in the market, where is 2,00,000, where is 240,000, okay, where is 180, where is 19? See, how much jealousy will be there for Oracle now? There should be some kind of feeling with it, right? Just to beat Oracle, they started looking for, again, you know, acquiring back to Oracle over there. They started looking for, like, you know, I want to acquire you, come, please come and merge into our company. They said no. Oracle people requested Salesforce.com so many times, like, you know, please come and merge into our company. How much ever we want to give it to you, we'll give it to you. Please request how much ever you want to have it. So they said no. Okay? Just to beat Salesforce.com, Oracle acquired Siebel CRM. Okay, just to beat Salesforce.com, okay, Oracle is a very big software company, Oracle itself, and Oracle acquired Siebel CRM over there. Hope you heard about Siebel CRM. It's a number one CRM in the software market. Okay, and just to beat Salesforce.com CRM, they acquired, like, Siebel CRM over there. Okay, so very big company. Siebel itself is a very big company. And then just as soon as Salesforce started their own programming languages called Apex Programming and Visual Force Pages, so the number one technology in the market is Java programming. Okay, Java by Sun Microsystem. Okay, Oracle acquired Java also. Okay, all of these three companies combined together also, they tried to beat Salesforce.com, but nothing happened with the help of Salesforce.com. Okay, they tried with the different versions, lot of things, they're spending a lot of money to sustain their existing customers from SQL, from Java, from Oracle, and again, all of them combined together, they want to beat Salesforce outcome in the market, but no, they have their own innovative idea, they are going through these things and all. So one more thing, one simple logic guys are here, okay, if the customer doesn't believe in the technology, if the customer doesn't believe in saving the cost, if the customer doesn't believe in the flexibility they provide by Salesforce.com, the customer doesn't believe in the time they're saving over there, okay, why 244,000 customers are using Salesforce.com without using their own server, without maintaining their own hardware, without maintaining their own software, okay, because you don't know your logic will be there, right? You got it? And only one, why? Yep, sorry.
Yeah, I said because they want to save when they don't need to use hardware, they don't need to have their own system, they can use everything through the cloud and
exactly.
Someone else.
Yeah, that because you are going to save the cost, you are going to save the time. Okay?
Yeah.
Even if you are going to maintain your own hardware, own software, is there any guarantee that nothing will happen to your software or servers? There's no guarantee, but Salesforce.com, because if you are going to use Salesforce application, they are providing the 100% SLA. So within a fraction of seconds, within a fraction of hours, we'll get everything up and running for you. Even if you want to maintain your own backup servers from your current location with the help of hardware software, maximum 2 locations, 3 locations, up to 10 locations you can maintain. That depends on the biggest company. You can go for 10 different locations, you can maintain the backup server. And each thing you need to have minimum 6 servers needed over here. So one single server, one single location, 6 servers you need to maintain, and how many number of locations you want to maintain, that's up to you into 6 servers over there. But Salesforce.com, okay, maximum, this is the maximum you can go maintain over here. But Salesforce.com, they're going to replicate the backup of your application, backup of the stage into multiple number of instances being provided by Salesforce.com. Over there. Depends upon the network bandwidth you are going to have it, whichever the servers for you nearest by to you, the respective location will be connected to you. Okay, I'll show you in the next class tomorrow morning, okay, same time, I'll show you how we are going to get the register for Salesforce.com, how we are going to learn Salesforce.com going forward. I'll show you tomorrow again. I want you to meet for half an hour more tomorrow. So I'll explain you how do you connect to Salesforce.com, what is needed for Salesforce.com, so how they provide the services to all of our customers, how do they provide the space over there, how do the benefits are going to come, how the new fees are going to come from Salesforce.com. We'll see all of them tomorrow's class.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
So. Yeah. Okay, just go through the recording and just to practice on Salesforce.com, just to learn Salesforce.com, what exactly we need to have it, and then how the client's routage will be implemented by Salesforce.com. We'll see all of them tomorrow. I can continue further more, but I don't want to take much time here because already we crossed 1 hour 20 minutes, so I don't want you to take extra time now. Okay, we'll take tomorrow. Maybe you can request we can request the team to arrange the session one more time tomorrow. We can extend this today's class, and if you have any more doubts on today's class, we can discuss tomorrow. Okay. So even let me extend a little bit here. So Oracle tried a lot to acquire Salesforce.com. They said no, and by looking at Oracle again, Microsoft also tried a lot to acquire Salesforce.com. Again, they said no. So IBM also tried. Google also tried. So for all of them, they become the partners. They're helping them to build their to sustain their own customers. Okay, there may be hundreds of thousands or lakhs of companies out there in the market. Their main motto is convert everybody to use cloud over there. Convert everybody to use cloud. Okay, they don't want to use hardware. They don't want to use any kind of software, something like that. So just because of that, so Oracle or Microsoft cannot say that we are not a software company. But Salesforce.com is the only technology we can say that we are not a software company over there. Okay, when you open Google, when you go to Salesforce.com, you can see Salesforce.com, some name will be there, and down you can see software, and you can see red color line will be there. Salesforce.com is not a software. Okay, Salesforce.com is a software for Salesforce.com company, but Salesforce.com is a service for all of our customers like this. Okay, so tomorrow we'll see how the space will be provided, how the application access will be provided, how do you start practicing in Salesforce.com, just maximum half an hour, we'll discuss in the same time. It's fine?
Okay.
Yeah. Thanks, Isaac. If you have any more doubts and if you have any more feedback, please provide to the team so we can improvise and we can go forward. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you.